During the course of the lifespan of an FSP license, there will be a communication with various divisions of the FAS regulator. This chapter gives you an understanding of the various FAS departments and their responsibilities. It also explains the impact and effect of an undesirable business practice. Here is a look at the FSP overall structure. And here is a more detailed look at the structure. Let's look at the role of the Enforcement Committee and Board of Appeal. The Enforcement Committee is an administrative body that adjudicates on alleged contraventions of legislation, regulations, and codes of conduct. The EC may impose unlimited penalties, compensation orders, and cost orders. The decisions are enforceable as a judgment of the Supreme Court, and the Registrar and the EC do not have dual jurisdiction. The Board of Appeal is an independent tribunal, and the members are neither employees of the FSB nor active participants in the financial services industry. Let's look at three of the departments within the FAS division of the FSB, namely the Registration Department, the Supervision Department, and the Enforcement Department. The Registration Department is responsible for new license applications, profile changes, updating the Central Representative Register, approval of mandates and application forms for discretionary FSPs and administrative FSPs, responsible for lapsing of licenses, queries on license status, and collection of levies together with FSP Finance Department. The Supervision Department is responsible for implementation of a risk-based approach to supervision of financial service providers, responsible for analysis of financial statements and compliance reports, responsible for conducting on-site visits to FSPs and compliance officers, and responsible for liaising with industry relating to changes in subordinate legislation. The Enforcement Department is responsible for dealing with complaints against FSPs that could not be referred to the FAS Unit, responsible for investigations into the affairs of FSPs, responsible for regulatory actions such as suspension and withdrawal of licenses, responsible for updating debarments on the Central Representative Register, responsible for reinstatement of representatives on the Central Register. Most of the interaction with the Registration Department happens by completing and submitting prescribed forms. The Supervision Department receives the compliance reports either electronically or hard copies, and may request additional documentation electronically or in hard copy. The Enforcement Department requires completion of forms, such as complaints and applications for reappointment of debarred persons, and may also request additional documentation electronically or in hard copy. You know by now that whenever there are changes in the information relating to the FSP submitted during the application, the FAS Department must be notified within 15 days of such changes. These changes are referred to as profile changes. Key individuals must ensure that there are adequate processes in place to manage completion and submission of the relevant forms. Each profile change requires a fee to be paid to the FSB. Here is a summary of the profile change forms. The FAS Act is functional and exists together with other legislation in relation to its purpose. Financial services are impacted by many laws relating to financial products, security-related legislation, insurance-specific legislation, as well as consumer protection legislation, to name a few. Business needs to constantly align its practices and compliance with applicable legislation. The key individual must ensure that there are procedures and systems in place to identify and flag changes in legislation. An example of such a process is subscription to a service provider that specializes in updating business with changes, alerts, and updates. Industry associations offer valuable platforms for sharing and gaining information and knowledge. It is also important to take note of any changes and information emanating from the FSB and other regulators. Once identified, the required action must be taken to ensure compliance. It is also important that the key individual stays up to date with changes and updates in the phase legislation, including the subordinate legislation. In terms of Section 34 of the Phase Act, the Registrar may declare business practice undesirable after consultation with the Phase Advisory Committee. This may be done for a specific FSP or a category of FSPs. Before declaring a business practice as undesirable, the Registrar must first consider the following. The business practice must have, or is likely to have, a direct or indirect effect resulting in harming the relationship between FSPs or any FSP or category of FSPs and clients or the general public, unreasonable prejudice to clients, deceiving any client, unfairly affecting any client, and if allowed to continue, the practice will defeat one or more of the objects of the Phase Act. If the Registrar is convinced that these requirements are met, the following must happen. 1. The Registrar must publish an intention to make the declaration in the Gazette and provide reasons and invite written representations to the Registrar. 2. The declaration then gets published and the FSP concerned must stop with the business practice on or after the date of publication in the Gazette. This refers to the actual declaration, not the intention to declare. 3. If the FSP carries on with the business practice after the date of the publication, the Registrar may inform the FSP to rectify or reinstate to the satisfaction of the Registrar any loss or damage which was caused by or arose out of the carrying on of the business practice concerned. 4. The FSP who must rectify or reinstate must do so within 60 days after the direction was issued. 5. If the FSP does not adhere to the Registrar's directive, a fine not more than 1 million or imprisonment of not more than 10 years or both may be imposed in terms of Section 36 of the Phase Act. It is important that FSPs and key individuals ensure that the press and specifically the FSP website and the Government Gazette are checked on a regular basis for notification of undesirable business practices, because one is not allowed to do business with an FSP whose business has been declared undesirable. The key individual must ensure that the relevant areas and departments of the business are aware of a declared undesirable business practice. Business must also be informed not to continue doing business with or using the services of an FSP whose business has been declared undesirable. A summary of this chapter. Communication with the Phase Registrar includes the following. Interaction with the Registration Department, which is responsible for new license, profile changes, the representative register, lapsing of licenses, queries on licenses, and collection of levies. Interaction with the Supervision Department, which is responsible for risk management of FSPs, investigations, analysis of compliance reports and financial statements, on-site visits, and liaisons with the industry on changes in subordinate legislation. Interaction with the Enforcement Department, responsible for complaints, investigations, regulatory action, updating debarments, and reinstatement of debarred representatives. It is imperative that the business and key individuals are up to date with the regulatory universe in which they operate. Key individuals must ensure that the relevant people in the business are up to date with changes and developments in the financial services environment. The Registrar may declare a business practice as undesirable. This has severe consequence for the business. The Registrar will publish an intention to declare first. The FSP may then respond. Thereafter, the Registrar may publish the declaration, and the FSP must stop with the business on or after the date of publication. Failure to stop, rectify, or reinstate may result in a fine of 1 million and or imprisonment for 10 years.